what Christianity is about, read the first epistle of St. John. The themes of, on one side, the light and the life and the love and God all being on one side, and death and darkness and lying and the devil being on the other side, and how you're either with it or you're against it. All of these themes carry through in the gospel. And if we focus on just one of the major themes, which is the theme of, obviously, of love, we understand that the love that God is speaking to us about, if you are listening to the first epistle taken from chapter 4, he says, beloved, first off, that we are loved. Beloved, we are loved. Beloved, if God so loved us, we ought to love one another. And the small, simple message from this is that the love that has been given to us has to be enacted in our life. We have to live with that love. We have to love in the same way that God loved us, which might seem impossible, but it is with the grace of the Holy Spirit that we can do this great act. And of course, they will know us how? They will know us by our love. So how is it that we're supposed to love? We have sometimes a wrong understanding of the word love. Someone will say, I love pizza, or I love this movie, or I love this book. That's the wrong understanding. And in fact, I'll tell you how wrong it is. One of the priests on the West Coast, he gave this example. I might have given it here before. I like to use this example. Someone says, I love apples. I love apples, right? But what do you do to an apple? You bite it. You eat it, you destroy it so that it fills you. What you're really saying is you love yourself, and this apple is going to help you love yourself. But this is not the love that God is giving us, and this is not the love that He's teaching us. The love that He's teaching us is a love that means suffering, and that we're willing to die for the person, whoever it is in our life. We love our husbands, we love our wives to this extent. We love our children to this extent. We love our brothers and our sisters to this extent. We love the strangers. We love the sick. We love the hungry. We love the thirsty. We love those who are in prison to this extent. This is how we know that God abides in us, because we practice this love.